The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
As our brother Drew has died with the Lord, so may he live with him in glory.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. To you our praises due in Zion, O God. To you we pay our vows, you who hear our prayer. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
At this time, I would like to invite Deanna McKenna, Nancy Mercier, and a couple of their friends to come forward to share with us some words of remembrance. Please be seated as we listen to these words.
I would like us to take a moment to silently reflect upon Drew Everett McKenna and his significance to you personally. Reflect upon his magnificent smile and give thanks that he touched upon your life. Sometimes a voice can be loud and not heard, but yet Drew spoke by other means, like kindness, a pure heart, a welcoming smile. Drew had a presence. He was the epitome of a genuinely kind and decent man, an aspiring young man. He emanated warmth, acceptance, integrity to people he met. Some became life bonds, to some just a noticeable character that somehow wanted to make them a better, kinder person. He drew an audience, not even realizing the magnitude of the positivity he radiated. Drew loved listening to stories. I love sharing stories with him. He would laugh listening to his mom's and I's crazy antics from the past with a grin never leaving his face. Maybe we shared too much. Who knows? We were entertaining at most. He warmed my heart. The wreath room, his happy place, a lot of our happy place. His mom, dad, Dee, Heath, Shay, Kathy, Sean, every person who experienced sharing moments of laughter and camaraderie there, where the spirit of Christmas lives all year long. I am so very thankful Drew was part of my story. It is hard to let go of people we love most, the relationships we cherished, but we are not letting go. We are readjusting. We are redirecting that bond. How his presence will be in other aspects of our life. If we could only have one more day, always that one more day. Drew, a kindred spirit, a gentle soul. He was the perfect son and brother. He loved his family above and beyond. If I took the time to list all the attributes that define Drew, the list, as you know, would be endless. Drew was Christ-like, loving, kind, sincere, good to the core, and I loved him. I, too, wish there was one more day.
morning, everyone. My name is Deanna McKenna, and I am the eldest sibling of Drew McKenna. On behalf of my family, I would like to begin by thanking everyone that is here today and for those that have sent their condolences. We have received countless phone calls, emails, texts, flowers, meals, visits, and thoughts and prayers. They have been both comforting during this difficult time and have been a reminder of the impact Drew had on so many. We are gathered here today in the memory of my baby brother, Drew, so that together we may acknowledge and share both our joy in the gift that his life was to us and the pain that his passing brings. As I look into the crowd of people mourning for him, I find comfort in knowing that you all love my brother. I find peace in knowing that he touched your life and that you also touched his in some way. I find happiness in knowing that he will live on in all of your memories. Drew was the youngest of five children. He shared good humor and a big smile with everyone he met. He loved going to the gym and had the body of a Greek god and was marvelously handsome. He loved sandwiches and other food items made by my mom. He loved to tease his father, brothers, and friends. He loved to laugh and found delight in everyday life. Drew enjoyed camping with our family at Hermit's Island, walking the beach and laying in the sun. He loved summertime motorcycle rides and lounging by the pool. He loved playing Xbox and spending time with our family's pets. He enjoyed time with friends and made everyone in our family laugh. He did the best impressions of people and had a natural affinity for telling a story. He was our bright light, our sunshine. The world will never truly be the same without Drew, but we will hold the memory of him close to our hearts for the rest of our days. He was an incredible model of how to live our lives. He left us a part of him that neither time nor even his death can ever take away. I know you are looking down on us, Drew, with that signature smile. This is not goodbye. It's see you later. We love you forever and always.
Please stand. Let us pray. Lord our God, you are always faithful and quick to show mercy. Our brother Drew was suddenly taken from us. Come swiftly to his aid and have mercy on him and comfort his family and friends. By the power and protection of the cross, we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. At this time, I would like to invite Mark Brennick to come forward to proclaim the first reading from the prophet Isaiah. Please be seated.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, behold our God to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we all looked. Let us rejoice and be glad he saved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation. One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Have pity on me and answer me. Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me. The Lord is my light and my salvation. I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. You are the salt of the earth, but if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand, where it gives light to all in the house. Just so your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Before I begin my homily this morning, I just want to extend my sympathies and the sympathies of the entire Catholic community to all of you, especially to you, Mark, and you, Laura, and all of your children. This is most certainly a tragic and difficult time, and so please know that we're all praying for you, and we're going to continue to do so in the days and weeks to come. You know, there is nothing more tragic than when someone we love dies. It doesn't matter whether it's a coworker or a friend or even a beloved family member. But we know that when something like this happens, there's nothing that can prepare us for the whirlwind of emotions. You can't possibly prepare for a situation like this. You know, our Lord sometimes calls death a thief, something that robs us of a precious person, either takes our life or the life of someone we love. And when it's sudden, it can leave us feeling vulnerable and shaken. And over the past few weeks, I think all of you, especially Drew's family members, have probably experienced Drew's passing in the same way. It seems like someone who you loved was just taken from you so suddenly, and it was tragic. And I suspect, in fact, I know that as you sit here today, you're probably still dealing with some shock and disbelief, like it's a nightmare that just doesn't want to end. And of course, your grief is further extended, further deepened by the fact that there were probably a lot of things you would have loved to have said to Drew before he died. A lot of stuff that you would love to have done. Death has really robbed all of you of something so great in a short time. You know, one of the problems of experiencing a sudden loss is that when we feel, when someone like that, someone dies, as Drew did, we're not just robbed of the person whom we loved. We're also robbed of our own sense of security, our own sense of the future, and even our joy in life. You know, the fears and emotions that you're all feeling today, they're natural to those who lose a loved one. It's natural to ask, why him? Why us? Why now? And after such a shocking loss, it's natural to feel like your life has no direction. And may even feel like your life has no purpose. You know, that's the tough thing about death. It feels like, you know, when it comes, it leaves us broken and in tears. Those are human realities. But I'd like to share with you some things in life that death can't take from us. First of all, death can never rob us of love. Death can't take away the love we have for our deceased brothers and sisters. It certainly can't take away the love and the relationship that you all had with Drew. Can't take away your memories. All of that survives death. Not only is Drew alive in your memories and in your hearts, but he's really alive and being taken care of by the Lord. And now we pray that through God's love and mercy, Drew is looking down and hopefully praying for you. And we pray that he has a vantage point in heaven where he can see what's going on with you. We can see what's in your heart and can know all the things that you wish you said to him. That's our prayer for today. And so, my friends, realize that even this moment, Drew is still very much a part of your life. Death can't take that away. Now, secondly, for those of us who have faith, death can't take away hope. We hope that our brother Drew is with God in heaven. We pray that he's up there rejoicing in the gift of everlasting life, which was promised to him when he was baptized. And we hope and pray that one day we'll join him in that place of joy and happiness, where death can no longer exact its sting. Now, how can we be confident in the face of such a tragedy? I think if we have faith, and if our lives are focused and centered on Jesus Christ, while that won't take away the pain that we feel, it can help us to remember that there's something else beyond this earth. Jesus faced his own human death, the death on the cross out of love for us. And for those of us who have studied the Christian story or of the Christian faith, we know that his death was not the end. We know that he rose and he went ahead of us in heaven to prepare a place in the kingdom with the Father. You know, in doing all of this, he showed us that faith and hope can triumph over earthly death. Now, of course, this does not mean that we won't struggle in coping with the loss of a family member or friend, especially if that person is our son or daughter. In fact, that type of loss may be one of the most difficult challenges you all will face in this life. It's important for all of you, especially for you, Mark and Laura, to know that your grieving process doesn't have to follow a specific timeline. You know, you don't have to be over this in a month from now or a year from now. And there's no way that you or any of us have to grieve. And everyone goes through grief in a different way at different times in their lives. But remember that faith in God can help. Faith in God and, of course, belief in heaven will not take away our pain instantly. And they certainly aren't going to make up for any lost time that you feel you have now. But if you keep your eyes focused on God, if we keep our eyes focused on hope, those things can give us a perspective and greater confidence as we move forward in putting together the pieces of our lives. It is certainly difficult to cope with the loss of a family or friend, especially when it was so young and died in the manner Drew died. But I think there's some practical steps that we can all take. Now, of course, for the community, there's a lot we can do, especially when it comes to helping out Mark and Laura with their loss. I encourage all of you here in the days and weeks and months to come to reach out. Reach out to them and their kids. Send cards. Let them know you're praying for them and that you haven't forgotten them. Drop off food, you know, and have masses said for Drew. And remember, too, that the family's grieving process can't be rushed. Give them grace, because that's what God will give them. And I probably am preaching to the choir when I say this, but if there's any speculation that you hear about the events that led up to today, speak up. and charitably remind your brother and sister that they're repeating gossip, words that will wound. State clearly and lovingly that you prefer not to hear those words again, and then instead ask those people to speak words of prayer to God for Drew and for his family and for the consolation of his family and friends. Knowing that they have people in their corner will be a huge help to them. And for Laura and for Mark and for to all your children, remember this, that you are loved. All the people who are here today are here because they love Drew and they love all of you. Don't forget that. And remember also that this church that you're in right now, it's your spiritual house. It's a place of healing. You know, throughout history, many Catholics have come to their churches and leaned on their faith in their church community during times of loss. While it hasn't taken away the pain of that loss, the practice of the faith has helped many of our brothers and sisters cope with loss. So I encourage you, keep coming to Mass and keep leaning on Jesus in the Eucharist, as he will provide great strength and healing for you. And trust me when I say that if you come regularly, Jesus will help you and sustain you in the healing process. As we gather in this church today, we're all taking the first steps toward healing and learning to cope with this tragic loss. Drew's death was unexpected. We can't say that it was unprepared for. On the day of Drew's baptism, he was cleansed of original sin and set aside for God. And on that day, a seed of faith was planted in him. And every prayer he ever said, every mass he ever attended, every good thing he ever did, has prepared him for the day when he would meet his Lord and God. He might not always have talked about it, and we might not always have recognized it, but that preparation was real. And we can trust that God saw all of that, and he will richly reward Drew's faith and actions as Drew's gone to meet him. You know, there's nothing I can say that will take away the sting of this for anybody, but I can tell you this. Our brother Drew is in the arms of Jesus the Good Shepherd. And as we gather here today, let's pray that the Good Shepherd will carry Drew home to his place in heaven. And let's take this opportunity also to remember to pray for each other, that God will make his love known to us, especially in times of difficulty, and that we'll be given the grace that we need to make it through this hour. And then when the time comes for us to go and meet the Lord, then we'll be ready to be with him and to be with Drew forever. In the meantime, we say what's meant to be a temporary goodbye or so long, as the eulogist said in the beginning. And we commend Drew's soul to God. Drew, may you rest in peace. Please stand for the prayers of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. Oh, and at this time, I would like to invite Ian Brennick to the pulpit to assist us with the prayers of the faithful. At the end of each intention, please respond, Lord, hear our prayer.
For Drew, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brother, Drew, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we praise to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone to the Lord in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated as the altar is prepared for the liturgy of the Eucharist.
Be still, my soul, the Lord is on thy side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to thy God to order and provide. In every change, be faithful and remain. Be still, my soul, the best thy heavenly friend. Through thorny ways leads to a journey's end. Be still, my soul, thou God doth undertake to guide the future as he has the past. Thy hope, thy confidence, let nothing shake. All mysteries shall be bright at last. Be still, my soul, the waves and winds still know his voice who ruled them while he dwelt below. Be still, my soul, the hour is hastening on, when we shall be forever with the Lord. When disappointment, grief, and fear are gone, sorrow for God, love's purest joys restored. Be still, my soul, when cheers and chains is present, all safe and blessed we shall meet again.
Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
Accept the sacrifice at your hands.
As we humbly present these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Drew, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we all might escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by this same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Drew, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
On you stay.
Before I begin the distribution of Holy Communion, I just wanted to say how happy we are to have you all here praying and worshiping with us. For those of you who are Catholic and are able to receive communion, I encourage you to come down by the center aisle, and the deacon and I will be standing right here on either side of the urn. And when you approach us, you will receive the host either on your tongue or in your hands, and then stay there and consume the host, and then you may return to your seats by the side aisle. For those of you who aren't Catholic or for some reason aren't able to receive communion, you're invited to come up with your arms crossed like this, and that'll be a sign to us that you would like to receive our blessing. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Of Jesus say, come unto me and rest. Lay down thy weary one, lay down thy head upon my breast. I came to Jesus as I was, so weary, worn, and sad. I found in him a resting place, and he has made me glad. I heard the voice of Jesus say, behold, I freely give. The living water, thirsty one, stoop down and drink and live. I came to Jesus and I drank of that life-giving stream. My thirst was quenched, my soul revived, and now I live in him. I heard the voice of Jesus say, I am this dark world's light. Look unto me, thy morn shall rise, and all thy day be bright. I looked to Jesus, and I found in him my star, my sun. And in that light of life I'll walk till traveling days are done. Blessed are they who are poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of God. Bless us, O Lord, make us poor in spirit. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God. Blessed are they who are meek and humble, they will inherit the earth. Bless us, O Lord, make us meek and humble. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God. Bless Blessed are they who will mourn in sorrow, they will be comforted. Bless us, O Lord, when we share their sorrow. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God. Bless those who hunger and thirst for justice. They will be satisfied. Bless us, O Lord, hear our cry for justice. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God. Blessed are they who show others mercy. They will know mercy too. Bless us, O Lord, make us cry for mercy. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God. Blessed are they who are clean and holy. They will behold the Lord. Bless us, O Lord, make us pure and holy. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God. Blessed are they who bring peace among us. They are the children of God. Bless us, O Lord, may your peace be with us. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant, Drew, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
After this Mass, you're all invited to a luncheon downstairs to join Lori and Mark and their family for a time of remembrance and fellowship. And so please do join us downstairs in the parish hall as we gather together. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Drew, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Drew in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. is in the sea, you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. Blessed are your poor, for the kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are you that weep and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked tongues insult and hate you all because of me, blessed, blessed